I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole.
Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage.
Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. I thought about eating Christopher, but I held back. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it. My Halloween candy was all gone. Come out now.
Sweetheart, it's late. Go to sleep.
I kept eating and eating. I ate a lot of things that night. Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. And suddenly, I was a cat. I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared. Mom and Dad didn't even look at me. I jumped and I almost got her. I could tell she was getting really tired. Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird. I gobbled her up. And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass. His face looking up and seeing mine through my talons. I swallowed him up, and I didn't chew one bit. Then I flew off to find something bigger. A mama rabbit. She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark. And into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever. Juicy seals. opened my eyes, everything had changed. Now I was a monster, and I smelled people everywhere. Good smell went into an old pipe. I got closer and closer. All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to feed, and we both know I will be delicious.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.